It's on. Wow. I think we sold out. There are seats here, but we reached the maximum. And so it's quite a thrill for us at this particular point. This evening, our portion of the program will be really like a home concert. We're bringing back pieces. We have a few new ones, but bringing back pieces from throughout the year. But we have too much literature from the year to bring back everything. For instance, the wonderful Shakespeare piece. By the way, it's Billy's birthday today. Billy was born today, and he also died on this day. Unusual that he was born and died on the same day. Most outstanding colleges and universities have a home concert at the end of the year, where they showcase pieces from the entire year. We don't do pieces and then put them away and then grab a whole bunch of new ones. We keep them in our repertoire. It was a Friday the 13th of March last year, 2020. 1 year, 1 month, and 10 days ago, this choir had prepared all 21 choruses of Handel's Messiah in preparation to sing with professional soloists and orchestra. And on Friday, March the 13th, we had to make the unfortunate call that has led to this long, long situation. We are so fortunate that the college here has facilities that we've been able to rehearse up to this point in a huge room that gives us the distance that we needed at that time. We are fortunate that we've been able to find a way this year to make this happen. We've been resourceful. We've been perseverant. But mostly, we are thankful because we were able to let music work its magic on us all year long, 3 days a week. And even though it's been a year of distancing, great music always brings us together, really. Choral ensembles are family, and we come to care about each other, to encourage each other, to challenge each other, to forgive each other. We are there for each other. And the act of creating the choral art together is the thread that binds us together. Every year, we're there for each other every single year. But this year is different. Being there for each other this year has taken on a whole new level. I will miss you all. And I will remember our challenges. And I will remember our ability to overcome this incredible year. I am so glad for the trajectory that my life has taken, that my life's journey has taken, that it could bring me together with these wonderful people. Mom and Dad out there, Grandma and Grandpa, you raised some incredible people. They are awesome. Yeah, give yourself a hand. It's been an incredibly meaningful year supporting each other. The arts are the one place where we can take some refuge to express what it means to long to sing another day. And as I say, at the end of almost every rehearsal, I tell them to go out and spread the gospel of love. I'm not going to say any more. We're going to go straight down the list.
Thank you. dum dum diddly dum da dum dee 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 d
riding on this roller coaster ride. Round and round and round and round, I've seen the up and down side. And I'm here to tell you that the secret to life. Gotta be thankful, thankful.
very first song that we sang this year. All we are, we have found in song. You have drawn this song from us. And I don't think I can get through the rest of the decks without crying. Thanks for coming this evening. Thanks for entrusting your daughters and sons to our care for musical instruction. I learn from them every day. As incredible of individuals as they are, you must be incredible parents. Thank you for trusting Hutchinson Community College for us to help to educate them to become better and better citizens, musicians, whatever. They're not all going to be professional musicians. Some of them could. Thank you for coming. Flight song.
start off with something a little bit more unconventional for you this evening, combining some music that we're very familiar with, in case you didn't catch it. That was, of course, Lady Gaga's Bad Romance, but presented in the same style that, you know, the one and only Johann Sebastian Bach might have envisioned it. And as we've learned here, Gaga can do Bach, but Bach can never do Gaga. So that was the Lady Gaga fugue. Now, we decided back in February to team up with my colleague, Dr. Nick Schroeder, on a jazz concert. And, you know, we decided that we like jazz. So our next tune here, St. Louis Blues, is, of course, one of the great jazz standards. And we're even going to have a little bit of improvisation here. So you're going to hear a little bit from our violist, Aubrey Peck, and our first violinist, Marissa Franz. And also, because someone forgot to add him to the program, just want to let you all know that Johnny Huggard is going to hold down the bass line for us. So this is our arrangement of St. Louis Blues. Thank you. quick round for our two solos, Marissa Franz on violin and Aubrey Heck on viola. All right, and this is the part where I tell the one corny joke that I'm definitely not going to stick with for the evening, but we're going to close our portion of the concert with Hamilton, selections from it. I imagine that's probably something that at least one or two people in this room are familiar with. And when we get to the last tune, there is going to be one little bit of audience participation. I'll make it pretty obvious. But we're going to finish out the last tune here with You'll Be Back, and we hope that, hey, you'll be back after intermission. So no comments from the peanut gallery back here. All right, and also, of course, you'll be back to see more concerts in the fall. So this is selections from Hamilton and CC String Orchestra. And sorry, one last thing. We have a couple of people who won't be returning to us this fall. We're going to miss them dearly in our founding year of the CC String Orchestra. So on second violin, we have Emily Winkler, who's graduating, and also Taylor Powers, our percussionist extraordinaire back there. The two of them will not be joining us back again this fall, but we miss them. I guess Johnny, too. Sorry, I was going to talk about him with the band, too, but... Okay, all right, so thanks, Johnny. Sorry, all right. All right, so this is selections from Hamilton, and you'll know the audience participation when you see it. after a short intermission while we get the wind symphony set up, and we'll be right back for many more loud noises for you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Of a couple of firsts this evening. The composer you just heard from, William Grant Still, was the first Black American to have a symphony played by a major orchestra in this country. We did not play that symphony. The strings were a little bit earlier. But this was his folk suite for band, featuring a few popular folk tunes, as you might guess, in a folk suite. The second piece we have on the program is a little bit longer, American Labor Songs by Kim Archer. She's actually a composer that you've heard from us before. If you came to our fall 2019 concert, you heard from her, and then if you watched the inauguration back in January, you heard from her again. She was actually the first woman to be commissioned by the president's own Marine Band to write something for an inauguration. Again, this is not that piece, but this piece, American Labor Songs, is actually very current events for us, because American Labor Songs, actually, I'm talking about the labor movement back in the early 1900s here in the U.S., which we're seeing quite a resurgence of that today. So, this piece, American Labor Songs by Kim Archer, is one that we've grown to like quite a bit. And once again, just like with the string orchestra, I'd like to recognize a few members of this band that won't be returning next year. So, hopefully, I don't forget Johnny this time. Okay, so, starting up front, we have Chauncey Lowen, who's going to be away, yeah. All right, so Chauncey, and then we have Paige Staggs here on the clarinet, and in the second row, we have Brooke Hamby, who's right behind me, so you'll see her in just a second, and we'll just, okay, there's Johnny Huggard, he'll be graduating as well. I didn't forget you this time. Okay, and our second row in the horn section, Max Rickard is graduating as well, and then in the saxophones, Kylie, you're leaving too?
Yeah.
Well, okay, I guess you weren't here a little bit earlier to tell me that. Okay, so Kylie Dimmitt in our flute section is also leaving. Sorry, Kylie. I guess I had to forget someone in our band, too. Okay, so back to the third row. Max Rickard in our horn section and in our saxophones. Saxophones, y'all are all staying here, aren't you? No, Sarah Ewing, you're leaving us. Wow, I cannot remember anyone's names. I should write cue cards next time. All right, moving on back to our trumpet section. We have R.J. Stovall. And it's Daniel Holling and Timber Allen. I actually remembered a whole section for once. All right, and in the back row, we have DeMarcus Meyer. And that's it in the low brass section. And for our percussionists, we have Hunter Spoon and, once again, Taylor Powers, who will be leaving us at the end of this year. So we want to thank them for all the time that they've spent putting up with me, because sometimes that's quite a lot. So. Without further ado, let's give these people a round of applause for their time here. We're gonna miss all of them. And thank you all for coming out tonight and sticking around for us. So without further ado, this is Kim Archer's American Labor Song. Thank you. Thank you all for coming out tonight. That's all we have, I promise. So, thank you all again for coming out, and once again, to use my string orchestra joke again, we hope that you'll be back in the fall semester. Thank you. Have a good evening.